इन्वेस्टिंग फर्म है। पाकिस्तान में हम सब जानते हैं कि रिसेंटली 2 ETFs हैव बीन स्टार्टेड और उसमें बहुत ही कम इंटरेस्ट है, यानी उसके आने के बाद हमने देखा कि मार्केट की लिक्विडिटी कम हो गई है क्योंकि फ्यूचर्स के जो स्टॉक्स थे वो कंबाइंडली ऑन एग्रीगेट बेसिस मार्केट का 60% वॉल्यूम ड्राइव करते थे। ETFs के आने के बाद चूँकि रेडी मार्केट में लॉट साइज ETF का स्टॉक्स का एक कर दिया गया है, जो कि किया जाना चाहिए था, फ्यूचर्स में चूँकि नहीं किया, तो फ्यूचर्स के अंदर अगर कोई ETF बास्केट को हैज करना चाहे, उसको आर्बिट्राज मैनेज करना चाहे, तो वो नहीं कर पाता। तो हमने देखा कि एक तो फ्यूचर्स के वॉल्यूम्स कम हो गए हैं और दूसरी तरफ हमने देखा कि ETFs में जो एक्सपेक्टेशंस थी डिस्पाइट के मार्केट मेकर मौजूद है, बट ETFs में वॉल्यूम्स नहीं आ रहे। सो इन्हीं चीज़ों को डिस्कस करने के लिए कि ग्लोबली ETFs में क्या हो रहा है, ट्रेंड क्या है, COVID-19 के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में हाउ इज़ वर्ल्ड एड्रेसिंग टू दीज इश्यूज़ एंड चैलेंजेस, टुडे वी हैव गॉट विद अस मिस डेब्री फोरा। She is the CEO of the ETF GI, which is one of the leading ETF research firms in UK. So, Debri, welcome to the show.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
Great. So, as I've given a brief intro in my local language, I would want you to give us a sort of overview as to what is happening around the world. How is world looking into the COVID-19 situation? How are financial markets addressing the challenge of liquidity? And what do you see? How do you look at the future of the ETFs?
Yeah, so that's an interesting question. What we've seen is the volume traded in ETFs has on many days hit records. And so ETFs have been able to handle significant trading volumes and significant inflows and outflows. So they really have busted a lot of the myths that they wouldn't be able to handle volatility or significant inflows and outflows. So I think they have performed very well. And we've seen that the use of ETFs in terms of net inflows have been very significant this year. We've had $293 billion of net new money going into ETFs through the end of June. Last year, through the end of June, it was $209 billion. And what we're seeing is investors are using ETFs to invest in many cases, less risky investments, so moving more into fixed income. And very significantly this year, we've seen net inflows into gold. So if you look at the flows into commodities, there's been $54 billion going in. Last year, at this point, it was only $6 billion. So we see some investors going into equity exposure, looking at investing in technology and healthcare, where they feel those segments will benefit from the COVID situation and from work from home.
Okay, great.